Si no, no.
Okay, here's my watermelon vine. And this is the biggest watermelon that I have so far. This is the sugar baby watermelon. The tendril is still green and it's yellow on the belly. As you can see. I've been asking a lot of people about when to cut it. And everyone seems to tell me when this tendril gets dry, and I don't know if it's just the tendril or if the whole vine's supposed to get dry when it's time to cut it. But that's one of them. I have more. And this is only one tomato or watermelon vine that took. Here's another one. This one's not so big, but it's cute and pretty. Let's see. Let's see. And I have a lot of the little bitty ones that are getting ready to sprout. Like, here's one right here. And another one. I'm trying not to move the vine as much, but I noticed that there's a lot like this. Well, as it just fell off, so I guess I'll keep throwing these out as they, because I don't want to lose any nutrients off the vine. As you can see, there's another one over there. Can't tell, this one doesn't look so hot. Here's another one, nice and green, and you can see the tendril is still green on that one, but that one's got quite a ways more to go. And there's another little one there. Still in all, I think it's doing well, just trying to see when it's time to get that one. So this off is my nectarine tree, and it's got one nectarine, and I guess it's ready. Let me check it. A little hard, but not too hard. It's nice and red. And I just got this nectarine tree this past March. So I chose this one because it had little fruits on it, so then you know that it's a healthy tree that does produce fruit. Okay, so the bigger shot of my garden, and I planted green beans, tomatoes, and cucumbers, and the cucumbers are invading the rest of the garden. I never imagined it was going to be as big as it is. This is the first time I've ever done any kind of garden. As you can see, those are all cucumbers here on the right. In the center row, there are the tomatoes, and down here on the bottom, which you can't see from this far away, but which I'll get closer, are my green beans. So let me show you some of the stuff on the tomatoes. I have a couple of little flowers, but nothing's turned into an actual tomato yet, so hopefully soon. Still have a lot of blooms on my cucumbers, they're going nuts. And I'll show you from in here. I planted the cucumbers next to the fence so it would climb the fence. There's a little cucumber here. Let me get the camera in there deeper. There's one there. So all my cucumbers are going to come up, but not at the same time as my tomatoes, which was my plan. But I don't know why my tomatoes haven't made it to the surface yet. And there's another little tomato. Here are my green beans that got all in a whirlwind also. I don't think that I have any fruit, or not fruit, but any beans on them. I picked the ones that were ready. And I'm just trying to see here. Something's eating my plants, but I don't know what. I haven't put any kind of pesticide on it because I took a zoology course this past semester and found out about what pesticides do to the honeybees. And we really need our honeybees. So I didn't want to use any pesticides. So if anybody knows of any organic pesticides, please do a comment or a message. And then here's just another shot of the garden. As you can see here, they all take it over. But here's some more cucumbers. And I even have little baby cucumber plants coming up. I don't know why. Like I said, for some reason the cucumbers have taken over. They're invading everything. But I love cucumbers, so I guess it's not a bad deal. I'm gonna get in here deeper. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little scared to get into my garden because I don't want to fight any snakes or spiders. And there's one. Okay, I'm 5'1", so this tomato plant is almost my height, so I'd say it's probably maybe 4'8", 4'9". There's not that many blooms on it, and I don't know, they're tall, they look healthy, but I don't see a lot of blooms on them, so I don't know if anybody knows what that means. I think they were big boy tomatoes. I think that's what the seed packet said. So if anybody knows anything about that, I would like to get some advice for those. But like I said, I don't have any tomatoes yet. Well, I guess that's all. Get another shot of my watermelons that I'm so happy and proud of. Of course, I didn't do anything. God and the earth did everything. And I guess when this tendril gets dry, that's when I will be picking this off the vine. But it's nice and green, as a sugar baby should be.